Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Marie-Louise Fjällskog from Faron Pharmaceuticals. Marie-Louise, it's great to see you. How are things?
Things are going great. Thank you for asking. How are you doing?
I'm very well. Now, I've been reading that you've recently started a new study, not the MATIN study that you spoke to us about last time, but something called BEXMAB. I wonder if you could give us a bit of an intro to it.
Yeah, so I think this is a very exciting study. It's our first study where we are combining bexmarilimab with another drug. So we're combining bex with standard of care in blood cancers. So this is a phase 1-2 study where we're looking to see about the safety of bex in combination with standard of care and also the efficacy in patients with blood cancers. And as you may know, that patients with blood cancers, if they don't get cured by the first line of treatment, the prognosis can be quite poor.
Oh dear, and I think that bexmarilimab, which I think is involved in both of these studies, one of its main things is that it can have a beneficial effect even in people who are quite far along in terms of their treatment.
So that is correct. So we have seen that in the MATIN study. In the BEXMAB study, we are started in patients with blood cancers that actually have received prior treatments. But we are also going to open a triplet combination where we are looking at patients that did not receive any prior treatments. So the rationale for wanting to treat patients with blood cancers with bexmarilimab is that, as you may remember, bexmarilimab is an antibody that is targeting CLEVER-1. And in blood cancers, we have a lot of this CLEVER-1 expression on the actual tumor cells. And that makes the cancer cells immune suppressive. So our own immune system does not recognize that we have cancer cells circulating around in the body. But with bexmarilimab, we can help the immune system to recognize those cancer cells and actually start killing off cancer cells. And we have seen in our own experiments that if we add bex to standard of care, whether it's just the doublet with azacitidine or it's the triplet, we see better efficacy. So if I can just go back and talk a little bit about the preliminary efficacy data that we have seen and safety data. So last week, we had treated the first 5 patients with a combination of bex and azacitidine. So these are the blood cancer patients that have received prior therapy. So in these 5 patients, we saw that we had a very good safety. It was well tolerated. We did not see any dose-limiting toxicities at all. So we decided together with the investigators that we can go to the next level. So that is very exciting. And furthermore, the first patient that was treated in the study actually had a partial response. And this is really exciting because this patient had the standard of care azacitidine before, and he stopped responding to it. But now when we add bexmarilimab, we see a very nice reduction of the cancer cells in the bone marrow. So very exciting news.
Now, I know that your expertise is mostly on the clinical side, but would you be able to give us a bit of an overview of what it could mean for the business?
Yes, I think this is super exciting to open up a new study, a combination study with our drug that we have shown that we have immune activating effects. But with the first patient seeing a partial response, it's super exciting. So I can't wait to enroll 5 more patients and see what the next dose level can do. So this is very important for Faron, and it opens up for thinking about coming studies with other combinations.
Now, returning to, I think, what is the most long-running study, MATINS, could you give us any kind of an update on the latest news from that one?
So the MATINS study is ongoing, and we have evaluated the drug, single-agent drug, in more than 200 patients, and currently we're looking at a little bit more frequent dosing. So the results that we've seen so far is like 30 to 40% of the patients get a stabilization of disease, so the tumor stops growing. And this translates into a great overall survival benefit. So actually what I can tell you is that in one of the subgroups, in refractory melanomas, we do see a fantastic survival benefit where we see a 3 to 4-fold longer survival in those patients that get some efficacy from bexmarilimab. So that's exciting moving forward.
Yeah, fantastic. And you did earlier just touch upon a potential third study. Is there anything more you can tell us about that?
Yes, so we are super excited about working on a study called the Bex Combo. So we know that, you know, PD-1 blockers are very exciting. A lot of patients can get some efficacy from PD-1 blocking to like encourage your own immune system. However, most of the patients do not respond. So 80% do not respond. And what we have learned during the last years is that to be able to respond to PD-1 blocker, you need to have an immune activation that is already there in the tumor. And we know that bexmarilimab can actually induce this immune activation. So by combining bexmarilimab with PD-1 blockers, we hope to have a much better efficacy in those patients that didn't respond to single agent. We're writing on the protocol right now. We're submitting to the health authorities by the end of the year and hope to start treating patients next year.
And just finally, Marie-Louise, would you be able to just summarize for us in a very brief few words what it is that this research might ultimately mean for people suffering with various forms of cancer?
So we know that the immune system is really important for any drug to work for patients with cancer. And we have shown with a single agent that we can cause an immune activation. So the next step, what we're doing right now, is to see how much can we help like the standard of care drugs out there. So what this could mean is that we're hoping to be able to help patients that did not respond to single agent any kind, but PD-1 blockers, for instance, to get a much better response. So we do believe that we can help many, many patients to get better responses to cancer therapy.
Well, let us wish you the very best of luck with that one. Marie-Louise Fjällskog from Faron Pharmaceuticals.
Thank you so much. Have a great day. Thank you.
You too.